Hey, arts people. It's an interesting case. It doesn't give a whole bunch on where the case or what jurisdiction or district. It says it's a San Francisco based place, but can a horse sue? I wish people could sue, in a horse's favor, but the headline here is a horse sues former owner for negligence for 100K. Evidently this horse was pretty much neglected. 8-year-old quarter horse named Justice. Groundbreaking lawsuit. Former owner, severe neglect. Former owner, it was a woman. Rick, why are you always picking? I'm just saying. Most horses taken from people are women because most women own horses. Anyway, so this woman neglected her horse, leaving her outside. Weight loss, prolapsed penis from frostbite, lice, rain rot. She just neglected it, but she loved it. I'm sure she was telling everybody, rode horses before she was born. She was a trainer, probably gave lessons somewhere, because that's what the horse world is now. But anyway, they filed a lawsuit. This victim, or this animal rights group, filed a lawsuit claiming that they want 100 grand. And if this were to go through, which I think would be really good, because people that abuse horses really have no consequence. When you neglect an animal or you tie a dog up or you abuse it and you let it starve, they usually come and take the animals. They really don't do much for you. There's not a whole lot of jail time. There's not a lot of reason for the DA to spend a lot of time to criminally prosecute you. This woman actually took a plea deal and pled guilty. And I think she agreed right down here. The animal was removed. She pled guilty, criminal animal neglect, probably a misdemeanor, no jail time, maybe a $50 fine. As part of the plea agreement, she agreed to pay restitution for the cost of the horse's care prior to July 27. Now, depending on when the horse was taken and when it was put back, all the dates and everything, Animal Defense League or Defense Fund is the one that filed the suit. The Oregon Supreme Court previously recognized that animals should be considered victims. So what they're going on the premise is that victims have rights, and if an animal is a victim, then it should have rights. But there's been a couple other cases where the courts have ruled that animals not necessarily don't have rights. And let's see, where was one of those? In 2013, legal personhood of a cartoon character, an appeals court ruled that animals didn't have legal rights of human beings. So that's kind of a fallback that everybody that sues, they're going to point to this case. And that doesn't mean this judge was right or that's the only case. But, and then in this court here, I guess a monkey picked up a camera and took a picture of himself, and somebody tried to sue for copyright of the photo. And evidently, they ruled that an animal doesn't have copyright of an animal. Let's see, lawsuit can't be filed claiming animals have copyrights of photos. And I swear, the way they write news articles now, you can't understand. They got to write them like freaking backwards. But anyway, I digress. Let's take a look at this horse again. And again, if this is a picture, rope halter, man, ribs, no butt muscle, frostbite on the penis, tail is, oh, that's not tail, that's the hock that's swollen. Anyway, when I see horses like this, it's just, I mean, it's great that rescue places take these, but there really is no justice for animals that humans. What's the old saying? You can judge a society by how well they treat their animals and the elderly or something like that. America fails miserably in the protection of animals and animal rights. Anyway, I thought I'd share the article. I thought it was interesting. We'll end it there. Moki's fine for all the people asking. He's not limping, but he got in a fight with the neighbor cat the other night. Now his tail's all swollen up. Looks like he got bit in the tail. So, but he's walking good, and his little ear's torn up. I'll get a picture of his ear later. Anyway, we'll end that there.